Welcome to Basketball U. If you're new to Basketball U, make sure you slam dunk that subscribe button. And just to make sure you don't miss a thing, make sure you tap that notification bell right after you hit that subscribe button. Basketball U, welcome back. It's good to see you again. Make sure to smash the like button as we continue to give you all the basketball content you need. This legendary role player is underrated in so many ways. Seeing early success as a McDonald's All-American, having his jersey retired at the prestigious basketball royalty, the University of North Carolina, Basketball U family, we give you Jerry Stackhouse. Stackhouse was a premier player from the time he was a sophomore in high school. He was the state player of the year for North Carolina in 1991 to 92, leading Kinston, North Carolina High School to the state finals. His senior year, he played for Oak Hill Academy with future college teammate Jeff McInnes, leading into an undefeated season. He was a two-time first-team Parade All-America selection and was the MVP of the McDonald's All-American game. At the 1992 Nike camp, he and Rasheed Wallace were considered to be the top players at the camp. There were some who considered Stackhouse the top prep player to come out of North Carolina since Michael Jordan. Stackhouse attended the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill, where he was a teammate of future NBA players Wallace, McInnes, and Shamon Williams. In his sophomore season at UNC, Stackhouse led the team in scoring with 19.2 points per game and averaged 8.2 rebounds per contest. He led UNC to a Final Four appearance and was named as the National Player of the Year by Sports Illustrated and earned first-team All-America and All-ACC honors. While playing for Tar Heels, he was coached by Dean Smith. Following the season, Stackhouse cleared his eligibility for the 1995 NBA draft. Even though he left UNC after 2 years, he continued working on his degree and received his bachelor's degree in African American Studies in 1999. Stackhouse was selected in the first round of the 1995 NBA draft with the third pick by the Philadelphia 76ers. At one time, he was hyped as the next Jordan, since both players played at North Carolina, went number 3 in the draft, were listed at 6'6", looked similar physically, and had similarity acrobatic games. Coincidentally, both had a taller power forward from UNC drafted immediately after them in the number 4 spot, Sam Perkins in 1984 and Rasheed Wallace in 1995. In his first season with the Philadelphia 76ers, Stackhouse led his team with 19.2 points per game average and was named to the NBA's All-Rookie Team. In the 1996-97 season, the 76ers also drafted Allen Iverson. Combined, the two posted 44.2 points per game for the Sixers. Stackhouse represented the 76ers in the 1996 NBA Slam Dunk Contest. Midway through the 1997-98 season, Stackhouse was dealt to the Detroit Pistons with Eric Montrose for Theo Ratliff, Aaron McKee, and future considerations. By the 1999-2000 season, his second full season with the Pistons, Stackhouse was averaging 23.6 points per game. A year later, he had a career-high average of 29.8 points per game in a late-season victory over the Chicago Bulls. He set the Pistons' franchise record and the league's season high for points in the game with 57. In 2001, he led the NBA in total points scored, finishing second in the points per game scoring title to his former 76er teammate, Allen Iverson. Stackhouse saw his final action as a Piston with Detroit's elimination in the second round of the 2001-2002 NBA playoffs to the Boston Celtics. During the 2002 offseason, Stackhouse was traded to the Washington Wizards in a 6-player deal, also involving Richard Hamilton. In his first season with Washington, Stackhouse led the Wizards in points and assists per game with 21.5 and 4.5 respectively. Stackhouse became the only teammate to average more points per game than Michael Jordan for an entire season. Jordan averaged 20 points per game in 2002 to 2003, which was his last season in the NBA. Stackhouse missed most of the 2003-04 season while recovering from arthroscopic surgery on his right knee, playing in only 26 games. In 2020, Stackhouse stated that he regretted playing with Jordan as plays were being designed for an NBA legend who was past his prime, stalling Stackhouse's all-star momentum. In the 2004 offseason, Stackhouse, along with Christian Ladner and the Wizards' first-round draft pick, Devin Harris, was drafted to the Dallas Mavericks in exchange for former Tar Heel and NBA All-Star Antoine Jameson. He did not play for 41 games during his first two seasons with Dallas due to groin and continued knee problems, and played mostly the role of sixth man. During the 2004-05 playoffs, Stackhouse began wearing pressure stockings during games to keep his legs warm, to aid his groin injury and hold his thigh sleeves in place. The stockings also allowed for better blood flow to the legs. The practice quickly became a trend among NBA players, with Kobe Bryant, Tracy McGrady, Vince Carter, Dwayne Wade, LeBron James, and others adopting pressure stockings the following season. Stackhouse was still coming off the bench as the sixth man for the Dallas Mavericks during the 05-06 season. However, he was a significant factor in the NBA Finals series with the Dallas Mavericks against the Miami Heat. The Mavericks suffered, however, when Stackhouse was suspended for Game 5 for a flagrant foul on Shaquille O'Neal, and the Heat eventually won the series 4-2. Stackhouse was the third player from the Mavericks suspended during the 2006 playoffs. Stackhouse was traded to the Memphis Grizzlies on July 8, 2009 in a four-way trade. On the day of the trade, Stackhouse was waived by the Grizzlies. On January 17, 2010, the Milwaukee Bucks signed Stackhouse for the remainder of the 2009-10 season. On October 23, 2010, Stackhouse and the Miami Heat agreed to a contract. On November 23, 2010, the Heat waived Stackhouse to make room for Eric Dampier, who was signed to replace injured forward Udonis Haslem. On December 9, 2011, Stackhouse joined the Atlanta Hawks. Stackhouse was chosen to replace injured teammate Joe Johnson as Atlanta's representative in the Shooting Stars competition during All-Star Weekend. On July 11, 2012, Stackhouse made a verbal agreement to sign a one-year, $1.3 million deal with the Nets. Stackhouse has worn the number 42 in honor of Jackie Robinson, his favorite athlete, and became the first professional athlete to wear the number 42 in Brooklyn since Jackie Robinson. On November 26, 2012, the Nets played the New York Knicks for the first time since the Nets had moved to Brooklyn. Stackhouse played 22 minutes and scored 14 points, including a tie-breaking three-pointer in overtime, and the Nets went on to win. On March 18, 2013, he scored 10 points against the Detroit Pistons, one of his former teams. After the Nets' first round playoff loss to the Chicago Bulls, Stackhouse announced his retirement. On November 15, 2013, it was announced that Stackhouse had joined Fox Sports Detroit as a Pistons analyst. He primarily provided studio analysis, but also was the road color commentator for Fox Sports Detroit on select road trips. Stackhouse was also a college basketball analyst for the ACC Network and Fox Sports Detroit. By joining Fox Sports Detroit, Stackhouse reunited with his former Pistons teammate, Mateen Cleaves, in the studio. On June 29, 2015, he was hired to serve as an assistant coach by the Toronto Raptors. During his first season with the Raptors, he helped the team finish second in the Eastern Conference, along with reaching the Eastern Conference Finals. On September 9, 2016, the Raptors named him head coach for Raptors 905, the franchise's NBA Development League team, also known as D-League at the time. Stackhouse has inspirations of being an NBA head coach and told The Ringer that he hopes the D-League position will propel him to a head coaching job. Stackhouse led the 905 to a successful year during the 2016-17 season, as the team was crowned champion of the NBA D-League. Stackhouse was named D-League Coach of the Year in 2017. Stackhouse served as an assistant coach for the Memphis Grizzlies for the 2018-19 NBA season. On April 5th, 2019, Stackhouse was named the head coach of the Vanderbilt Commodores, signing a 6-year contract. His coaching journey to being an NBA head coach still continues for this amazing role player. From All-American MVP to a 2-time NBA All-Star to a D-League coaching champion, Jerry Stackhouse has so much more under his belt. Looking forward to seeing what he will do next in the future roads ahead in the game of basketball. This is Basketball U. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And also, follow all of our social medias right there in the description to keep yourself up to date, as this channel will have a lot of basketball, a lot of players, and a lot of training and more information on how to play the game of basketball. Remember, someone's always working. Are you?